My lips are lip syncing automatically. My eyes are blinking automatically. My ears are wiggling automatically. This is how I looked in my previous video. And well, the static expressions got boring pretty quickly. Plus, I had no mouth because animating that manually would have been a huge time sink. So I got an upgrade. Here's how. I tried two methods of getting my character to lip sync automatically. The first method I abandoned because the end result didn't look that smooth, but I'm going to show you what I did anyway because I think it's pretty interesting. I knew that Apple had facial recognition features that are mostly used for like accessibility purposes, and I knew that the voice recognition software I have on my computer could hack those facial expressions so that I could use them in my own code. I had a look at the different facial expressions Apple can recognize, and I saw two that would be ideal for making a basic lip sync animation: open mouth and pucker lips. Pucker lips, I was thinking, would be useful for sounds like wuh and ooh. So the plan was, my Apple computer would use its webcam to monitor my facial expressions. If my mouth opened, Apple would detect this, then pass the information on to Talon, which is my voice recognition software, where I would have a custom script that would then press a specific key, let's say O for open. When the key O was pressed, I would display an image of the pig with an open mouth, and I would do this by using Unity, which is a games engine. Then similarly, if I close my mouth, the webcam would detect this. Apple would pass this information along to Talon. My script would then press a specific key, let's say C for closed. That key press would trigger Unity to display the image of the pig with its mouth closed. And the same deal for puckering the lips. Apple detects it, Talon presses the P key, and the puckered lips image is shown. So firstly, I turn on Apple's facial recognition feature. Secondly, I wrote the short script which would trigger a key press based on the facial expression I was making. A face, paren, snake open mouth, go right, colon, slap, tab, word key, paren, odd. Thirdly, I wrote the script in Unity which would display the different images. So this section says that if O is pressed, show the open mouth image. This section says if N is pressed, show the closed mouth image. And this section says if P is pressed, then show the image with the puckered lips. And that was it. It's done. This is what it looked like. Hi. Hello. If I speak any faster, then it just all gets out of sync or freezes. I figured out the reason that was happening. I think Apple want an emphasized facial expression for it to count. So, like, you have to hold whatever pose you're doing for at least a short while for it to register. But in regular speech, your mouth closes and opens really quickly, so sometimes it just doesn't have time to register the event. I still thought that was a pretty cool use of Apple's facial recognition software, though, but it didn't really work how I wanted it to, and the lip syncing just wasn't reliable enough. So I moved on to plan B, browsing the Unity Asset Store to see if someone had already done what I wanted to do. What do you know? They have. This one looked like the most decent lip syncing software in Unity currently, so I got it and I spent a bit of time trying to figure it all out. What I learned was there are three main things you can do with it. One is lip syncing, two is automatic blinking, and three is just other general movements that you can trigger randomly or manually, or they might hook up to the lip syncing, which we'll show later. So I started off with the lip syncing. How this works in Salsa LipSync Suite is a little bit different to how a lot of other lip syncing software works. When I think of lip syncing, I think of listening for the different sounds in speech and matching those sounds up to the right mouth shape. So this mouth shape might be when someone says O, this one when someone says T, and this one might be A, and so on. Salsa doesn't do any of that. It's a much more lightweight program. What it does is take the waveform of a piece of audio, like this. Then when the amplitude, which is the height, is low, it opens the mouth just a little, and where the amplitude is high, it opens the mouth a lot. This generally translates to if you sound more excited and loud in your audio, the mouth will be bigger. And if you're more subdued and quieter, then the mouth will be smaller. It's an interesting way of going about things for sure, and something I haven't come across before actually. To get started, what I needed was three series of sprites, which are 2D images, which show the mouth opening a small amount, a medium amount, and a large amount. I plugged these into Salsa LipSync, configured a few settings here and there, and gave Salsa the audio file I wanted it to automatically lip sync. And that is all I had to do to get it ready. Pretty fast so far. This is what it spat out at this stage. Did you know that pigs have great memories? They can remember directions to somewhere, human faces, and places they've found food before. I quite like it. It doesn't capture the mouth shapes for the different letters like I mentioned, but because I'm animating a cartoon image, I don't think it matters quite as much. And it definitely is much more responsive than the Apple facial recognition method. I was quite happy with how that worked, so I moved on to the automatic blinking. It was a similar process as the lip syncing. I needed a few sprites to show the eyes blinking. Then I needed to give these images to Salsa and decide how often I wanted my character to blink. What I've typed in here means that the blinking will repeat every 1 to 2.5 seconds, so it's not always the same time between blinks, and that should hopefully look slightly more natural. This is what we have with the lip syncing and eye blinking put together. Did you know that pigs have great memories? They can remember directions to somewhere, human faces, and places they've found food before. I think it's starting to look quite good, but it's still a little stale. I think it would look a little bit more interesting if the ears and eyebrows also moved. I'll try and get the eyebrows to move up when I put more emphasis on words, because I think that would look quite natural. So it'll work in the same way that the mouth does. When the waveform amplitude is high, meaning the audio is louder, the mouth will open wider and the eyebrows will raise. Then for the ears, I'll just set their animation to trigger at random time intervals. And this is what I ended up with as the final result. I think it's pretty decent. A lot better than this was at least, and it should cut down on animating time in the future. I reckon there might be an upgrade 2.0 in the works to maybe add a few more movements and also to have a way to trigger some expressions like happy or sad or frustrated expression. Anyway, I know that this is pretty much just my second video, but I still just wanted to say thanks if you watched my last one or left me a comment, because I honestly walked around smiling all day anytime I got a YouTube notification, and it really made my day. So yeah, thank you, and I hope you have a good rest of your day.